Thank you, Dr. Mini. Now, I would like to invite our worthy principal, Dr. Pargat Singh Garcha, to formally welcome our esteemed resource persons of the day and our dear participants as well. Over to Dr. Pargat Singh Garcha.
Thank you, Dr. Ramandeep. Very good afternoon to August audience in the second day of this webinar. I extend a heartiest welcome to all of you on behalf of the Management Committee and Faculty of GHG Khalsa College of Education, Guru Sarsodar. As we just got a summary of last day's sessions through the first day report presented by Dr. Mini Sharma with all of us, we also got encouraging messages from across the nation for choosing this relevant topic for the webinar. Thanks to all for your appreciation to a small initiative by GHG Khalsa College of Education team for quality education. Your questions in the chat box of Zoom, YouTube, WhatsApp are the clear evidence that you all are really enjoying the sessions, and going one step further, you also feel that there is need of more sessions to put these tools into our practice. As you all know, covering each detail of 3-4 learning management systems within 5 hours is not possible. It is an initial effort for orientation toward these LMS. We will also plan some more hands-on experience in the form of online workshop in near future. So stay in touch. As last day we covered 2 LMS, today we will focusing upon another 2 LMS. The first one is MOOCIT and second one is a very simple but very robust Google Classroom. I recently developed one massive open online course on cooperative learning, and it was launched through MOOCIT platform. More than 4,800 learners who have joined this MOOC on MOOCIT really appreciated the platform. So we will be enlightened from the valuable words by Dr. Neeta Singh from IIT Kanpur about MOOCIT platform. I extend my hearty welcome to ma'am. The whole MOOCIT team is very cooperative. We are really thankful to the IIT Kanpur team for accepting our humble request for the session. Welcome, ma'am. Our second session on Google Classroom will be taken by Dr. Raju Talreja from Bombay Teacher Training College, HSNC University, Mumbai. Our college and Bombay Teacher Training College has already signed Memorandum of Understanding 2 years back, and our collaboration is benefiting both the institutions. Dr. Balani ji, principal, all the faculty member of Bombay Teacher Training College are really cooperative in any joint effort. So I also welcome Madam Dr. Raju Talreja ji as our source person of the second session. Dear participant, after each presentation, there will be a question answering session. You can write your queries in the chat box of the Zoom or on YouTube. Our team will be asking your question from your side at the end of the presentation, or we will give also audio control to some of the participants. Please note that do not write any self-introduction in the chat box. Sometimes continuous messaging in chat box disturb the audience as well as the resource persons during the session. So please accept my humblest of the humble request to focus on session related queries only in the last 20 minutes in the chat box. One more request, please do not post queries related to send us feedback as early as possible in chat box. The quiz and feedback form will be shared in WhatsApp groups. If anyone are registered for the webinar but not joined WhatsApp, he or she can contact the organizing team on contact number given on the webinar brochure. I will humbly request my teaching community to be more focused on learning part in these webinars. Otherwise, the certificate of these webinars will be just a piece of paper. Dear friends, we should be part of the webinar for learning purpose, not only for the certificate. 2-3 participants couldn't register on time for the webinar as registration was closed before the start of the webinar. But they requested us that please allow us to be part of the webinar without certificate. I salute the spirit of the 2 respected participants of our webinar today. So dear friends, let us focus on academic output of each webinar. Instead of a decorative mega shows and certificate ceremonies, we need to focus on academic output of each event organized online or offline. So in the end, I once again extend my heartiest welcome to all the respected principals from different colleges, principals from different schools, and the learned faculty from across the nation. So welcome to all. Sat Sri Akal. Over to Dr. Raman, please.
Thank you, sir. Dear participants, let's begin with our first session of this 2 days webinar. I am feeling extremely delightful to introduce our resource person. Dr. Neeta Singh is senior project scientist in Indian Institute of Technology, Kanpur. Ma'am completed her PhD in 2002 from Purvanchal University. Dr. Neeta did her master and bachelor degree in science with specialization in botany from Allahabad University. Ma'am has a vast professional experience span over many years, as she served as lecturer in Department of Botany at DAV College Kanpur from 2003 to 2006. She worked as assistant professor in environmental science at Maharana Pratap Engineering College Kanpur from 2006 to 2013. She also worked on Agropedia project IIT Kanpur from 2013 to 2015. Our esteemed resource person, Dr. Neeta Singh, has managed 30 MOOCs from 2015 to 2020. She has delivered 5 online lectures. Ma'am is organizing various workshops and courses in her field from the last 5 years. Now, I invite Dr. Neeta Singh to share her view on the topic MOOCIT as learning management system. Over to you, ma'am.
So thank you for such an elaborate introduction. And I really thank Dr. Pargat Singh Garcha and the organizing team for giving me this opportunity to present MOOCIT in a 2 day webinar on learning management systems. So I welcome all my participants, and I will start the presentation right away, because I have lots of information which I would like to cover in this session. Okay, so I would like to start the presentation now on MOOCIT. A little bit about MOOCIT, because in this webinar we are discussing learning management systems. And learning management systems are LMS. They are like LMS, and MOOCs are very different from learning management systems. MOOCs are massive open online courses. So in this talk, when I present, our participants will be able to learn the difference between learning management systems and massive open online course or MOOC management systems. So MOOCIT is a MOOC management system, which I am going to present, and it is very different from a learning management system. So with these words, I'm going to start the presentation. I will also like to give brief introduction, which I think already have been covered. So I will just start the presentation now. Okay, so MOOCIT, introduction and features. I'm a member of MOOCIT team, as it has been already informed. And MOOCIT team is a small team. The MOOCIT team actually is just not using the platform. We develop platform, we run MOOCs on the platform, we provide resource for offering MOOCs and running MOOCs on this platform. So this group has a very vast experience, right from the platform creation to delivering MOOCs. And you will see that later we have almost offered 170 MOOCs on MOOCIT platform through MOOCIT on various platforms. Okay, So MOOCIT. MOOCIT is a MOOC management system. MOOC stands for Massive Open Online Course. MOOCIT in 2019 became open source, which means it can be downloaded and people can use MOOCIT on their own. Designed and it has been designed and developed at IIT Kanpur. So which is very important, which is very special, because this is one indigenous platform, MOOC platform, which has been developed in our country. So which is very special. And it has been, we will see that it has been developed keeping the needs and requirements of a country like India. So these are the things which we are going to see in this presentation. MOOC management systems, a little bit about MOOC management systems. A MOOC management system provides efficient way to manage content, assessment, and interaction of an online course. Scalability and usability are critical features which have to be kept in mind. Instructors should be able to track student engagement and performance. That is another criteria which is very important for a MOOC management system. A brief history of MOOCs, just for most of our participants here must be familiar, but just we will go through this history. So this term MOOC was coined in 2008 by Dave Cormier from the University of Prince Edward Island for a course offered by the University of Manitoba. Then in 2011, MIT OpenCourseWare became the first largest collection of MOOC resources made available by a university. Then New York Times labeled year 2012 as the year of the MOOC. So before this 2012, activity was happening, but by then it has gained momentum. And then year 2012 was declared as the year of MOOC. Lots of potential was seen in MOOC, and discussions were going around that MOOC will transform the way teaching is done. So that was the significance. Oxford added the term MOOC to dictionary in 2013. And by 2019, there are around 13,500 MOOCs announced and offered, a huge jump. So let's talk about MOOCIT, what our journey. At IIT Kanpur, we offered our first MOOC in 2012, the year which was announced year of the MOOC. So we had entered in this area very early, and it was just happening, it was starting globally. No MOOC management system was available at that time because we were the early starters. And our team customized an existing learning management system, which is LMS, what we call, and found it complicated for and expensive to scale. So one point is very important here that learning management system are basically for organizations, for companies, for college system, where there is a classroom, there are limited number of students, learners, and learners gets permission to join the course offered on an LMS. So it was like changing an LMS system to offering MOOC was complicated, and that's why MOOCIT happened. So my team, under the able guidance of Professor T.V. Prabhakar, the technical team, they worked on it, and then they created MOOCIT. So design principles used behind MOOCIT, that the platform should be simple and intuitive, should be simple and intuitive in user interface. Students should be able to access course material without much hassle. The course creation and management should be simple for instructor and management team. It should support multiple platforms like mobile, tablet, desktop, should be accessed easily from all these three platforms, should be easy to scale and add new features. So what does it mean by easy to scale? MOOC is massive open online course. Massive means the minimum registration should be around 1,000, 2,000. So the platform should be able to support those number of students. So that is why it will become very expensive and unaffordable to offer MOOCs for large audience. So it should be easy to scale, that at low price, it can be offered to large number of audience. And use open source tech stack. This is about MOOCIT platform, and now I will actually go through the architecture of a MOOC. So MOOC is actually an event. We will see that MOOCs are designed for a different purpose, for a very large audience. There have been cases where lakhs of students have joined a course. At ITK, we offered a course on MOOCIT platform, and I will later discuss that course, and 50,000 learners were there in that course. So it's a totally different atmosphere, ecosystem for learning. And what are the architectural features of a MOOC? So MOOC, the architectural features the components are called facets, and these are the architectural facets of a MOOC. What are these? Let's have a look at it. These are educational resources. It's a teaching environment. So we have to provide learning materials. There are interactions between learner and the instructor. Identity management, who is doing the course? Is it a genuine person or somebody else? Because we offer certificates also. Certificates are also offered for MOOCs. And then assessment. Yeah, assessment is important for offering certificates and learning pace and learning, progress. Learning analytics is helpful in that. Certification is done. And then event management. So generally, for an organization, there is a semester system or annual system where the courses are offered and then they close. But it is not like that for MOOCs. MOOCs can be are offered at different times. And once a MOOC is going to be offered, it has to be publicized that it is going to be offered at this time. And because MOOC is for global audience, global learners. So they may not be aware of that there is a course like this. And then it is an event and which has to be managed properly. So there is another total and different section, how to manage MOOCs, even how to do event management for a MOOC. And I have been actually looking after AG MOOC portal for agricultural MOOCs, which is powered by MOOCIT. And we have offered 30 courses on that platform, and every course is of 6 or 8 week duration, but it takes 6 months or a year first to find an instructor. Then instructor takes time to create the course, and then we publicize, then course is offered. And when course closes, we also provide time for. Okay. Sorry for this. Yeah. So let's have a look at the architectural features of a MOOC and then MOOCIT features. What are present? Which architectural facets features are present in MOOCIT? So educational resources MOOCIT generally are in the form of videos, audios, learning links, files, etc. Interaction. Interaction happens in forum, hangout, and also through social media. Identity management is through email or phone number. So a learner has to have an email and then can join the register for the course. Assessment happens in the form of quizzes, which are graded automatically, and assignments can be given, which a student actually complete, upload, and can is graded manually, and then the marks are uploaded. Learning analytics is very important. MOOCIT has a very robust analytics section, and which is very helpful to instructors and MOOC managers to offer a course, good course, and run it smoothly. Certification, there is a provision for pre-built certificate templates, and we also offer blockchain certificates, which are tamper-proof certificates, a very latest technology. Students don't have to depend on the course of on the organization which is offering the course. They can access the certificate anytime, and it is a certified certificate. So these are the features of MOOC and our journey. Now, some numbers for MOOCIT. First course was offered in 2014, 2012, started experimenting with the MOOC platform, and then MOOCIT was ready, and the first course was offered in 2014. So we have been there for last 6 years, 6-7 years. Number of courses, as I have already mentioned, 165 courses, number of students, 3 lakh who have benefited from it. A big percentage is also of teachers who actually benefit from this course. And major portals which are powered by MOOCIT are Agricultural MOOCs, AG MOOCs, MOOC for Development, for Commonwealth of Learning Canada, ITK Outreach, offer courses on MOOCIT platform, and now online courses ITK is Flip Class. Flip Class is a concept where the earlier learning pattern is actually flipped. So like earlier, the classroom learning will happen in classroom, and then a student will go and do homework. So which is just in the opposite way in a flipped class, and flipped classes are offered on online courses of ITK. And then now ITK is going to offer courses on MOOCIT platform for next semester. And within India, there are other organizations which are using MOOCIT platform. Manage Hyderabad, which is offers diploma courses on MOOCIT platform. ISER Bhopal has used UNESCO Open Education for Better World courses by various universities are offered on MOOCIT platform. And also outside India, Fiji, Mauritius, Canada, Nigeria, Seychelles, Barbados. These are the nations which have used MOOCIT platform for offering courses. So am I going too fast or am I okay? Okay, I will continue. Please let me know. Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I going too fast or my speed is okay?
No, it's okay, ma'am. It's okay.
Okay, I will continue. Okay, ma'am. So who are the various stakeholders in a MOOC? And we will see what MOOCIT offers for these stakeholders. So MOOCIT for students. Very little learning is required to use MOOCIT for students. It's very simple, very user-friendly interface. Navigation is very easy. Later, if I find time, I will give a clear demo of the MOOCIT platform after covering the features here. And then special features for slow internet, audio only. What I mean hereby is that if the internet connectivity, the bandwidth is not good, then one can access the content in audio form through phone. So this is very special feature because there are many times in developing countries there are issues of internet connectivity and bandwidth. Adaptable to any screen size, desktop, tablet, mobile phones.
Students learn while they are on the move, so they can access the lectures anytime from their smartphones. And apps, we have apps for Android and iOS, both. So apps can be downloaded and used. Moocit for instructors, easy to use instructor interface. We will see that later. Create a course can be created with minimal hassle. View or download detailed statistics, which is available for instructors and very helpful in running the course. Gradebook can be generated and downloaded automatically on the platform. Integrated analytics with graphical views, very helpful for figuring out information. And Moocit has what Moocit has for system admins. So system admins are basically, they can be interested in offering a course, a small course or large course, and they are looking for something which is affordable. So for them, it's this information is very useful. It is, Moocit is very scalable and can run on low-end servers, large number of simultaneous users at a low cost. So we offer courses, and when there's a lecture is released, there will be like 600,000 learners online, and Moocit platform runs without any hassle. So these are the very special things for MOOC management system or MOOC. Administrators can add new features with only a basic technical knowledge. Menus in any language can be added easily. Already we have menus available in 6 languages on the platform. And so only menus will be added. Language of the course will be in which it is created. And Moocit as a service is available. Next. What Moocit for planners? So that was for administrators, and now it is for planners. So planners standard edition, like a simple platform can be created for a single course. Enterprise edition, a portal for where many courses can be offered. Replicated Moocit is for islands, island nations or remote areas. Later in this presentation, we will see through a diagram, it will be easy to understand what replicated Moocit is about. And Moocit for Mobi MOOCs. Okay, so Mobi MOOCs is also part of Moocit platform. And as name, it is evident from the name Mobi MOOCs. MOOCs are offered on mobile phone, simple mobile phone, dumb phone. A large section of our population, especially in any developing country, or maybe some elderly people who have not been part of this revolution, a smartphone revolution, they still use simple dumb phones. And the course content can be delivered in like IVR form. So learner can access it from a simple phone and learn from that. So this is also a Moocit feature which could be of use for planners. And Moocit offline, MOOC as open educational resource. So what happens, Moocit offline, sometime a course can be put on a SD card and given to learners in a remote area where internet connectivity is not there. So these are very useful information for Moocit planners. They can use all these features to offer courses, promote learning. Okay, so what is special about Moocit? We have discussed all those special features, and now we will just cover them here. So Moocit has been designed ground up as a MOOC management system, not an adapted LMS. So it's very important to keep in mind that learning management systems and MOOC management systems are different. Their ecosystem is different. They are actually used for different purposes. So one should not confuse LMS with MOOCs, MOOC management system. Simple and minimalistic design with the student in mind. and integration with social networking. So now the learning is going to a different level where people are learning from anywhere. They're learning from YouTube, they're learning from Facebook, they're learning from different places, wherever they can get information. The purpose of MOOC is promote learning. A student will not join learning just to get a certificate. A learner can join a course, a MOOC, just to learn a topic or just to learn one module. If a course is 8 weeks long, learner may be interested only in 1 week of content. And they are learning from social media. They are present on social media. So integration of social media is also seen as an special feature of a MOOC management system. And Mookit has it. So because they can see the happenings of a course on social networking platform, then that will remind them, okay, let me complete this activity. So that's how it's helpful. Designed for developing countries, Mookit has been designed for developing countries. It takes care of bandwidth adoption. It has replication when it can be, we will see that later what it means. And offline, as I mentioned, that SD card feature. Analytics, it has very robust analytics platform, integrated analytics platform. And it uses the state-of-the-art technology and architecture. So here in this diagram, in this slide, you will see what I have been talking about as bandwidth indicator. This where I have my cursor, this is bandwidth indicator. And if the signal, just like we have a bandwidth indicator or internet connectivity indicator in our phones, this tells the connectivity bandwidth strength. So bandwidth indicator helps to know in which form one can access the content. If it is good, one can access video. If it is not that good, then one can access slides synced with audio. So that is there. And this here shows the PDF and transcript which is available for a lecture. And this is a screenshot from from the course home of one of our courses. And we will see this later also. So here, the important thing is this bandwidth indicator, which is very helpful in a developing countries and a country where the signal is not stable, sturdy, and Mookit takes care of that. Mookit app is very helpful. We have Mookit app for iOS, Apple devices, and also for Android phones. The student can download the videos and watch them offline. Okay, what offline means here is, even if the internet connectivity is not there, the video can be downloaded within the app and then watched. So the stats is collected from this activity happening in the app and goes to server and gets synced. So if a course is offered, the management MOOC managing system platform knows that what activity a learner is doing. Analytics are synced once there is a connection. So information is there in the app, and when the phone connects, then the information goes to the main server. Messaging based needs less bandwidth. This means that whatever activity is happening in the course, it is information about lecture release or any announcement that comes to app in the form of message. So it doesn't take much, bandwidth. That's why it's good for, for those conditions where connectivity is not good and fluctuating and all that. Push information, notification to inform about new course material, which I have already mentioned. SD card support, course videos and material can be accessed from an SD card mailed to a student. A student is in a remote area, the content can be mailed on an SD card. There are programs which will help the sync information. So for instructors can upload lecture in multiple format, video, audio files, access to delayed analytics can see who is watching, who has watched video, can import mark to the platform. These are the features in which instructors will be interested. Assignments file can be uploaded, manually graded. Quiz for online evaluation. Quiz is generally multiple choice. Quiz has these types of questions, multiple choice, true, false, fill in the blanks. And quiz can be timed. It has, and can be also randomized. And even the options can be shuffled and randomized. So generally there is a concern that that student can consult each other or, you know, so having these options removes, takes care of that concern. Again, just a repetition, what are the features that will help lecture delivery modes, help like video, audio sync with PPT, and then in the form of audio, just the voice also, there, that is an option sometime. Bandwidth indicator is very helpful. Concept of attendance is like whatever lecture is watched by the student, whatever portion is watched by the student, all that information is there on the platform. And then that can be considered for giving a certificate. And if in the forum, one can create a message in audio form. A forum can be created in audio. So one can record a forum. Question in video, questions in video. So generally it is said that the video lecture should not be more than 20 minutes long, maximum. Ideal is between 6 to 14 minutes. And that is also sometimes when the learning is happening independently alone, that can be a little boring and a student can get distracted by something else. So there is a provision for putting questions in the video. So a topic is presented and a question will appear and the learner has to answer that question correctly, only then can move forward. So that is also, that feature is there in the MOOCIT platform. And that is also, this feature is also known as reflection point. So the reflection points is very important for learning activity. And in video questions are reflection points helping in learning. So unique features of MOOCIT, some more in now pictorial form. We talked about replicated directly to server. So we replicated version that we will see. So every learner connects directly to server. So there is no delay. Direct connection. MOOCIT replicated. So there's a main, the course is on the main platform and there's on another server in some island or remote area. So learner connect to this local server for accessing the course. And this local server, from time to time, when there is internet connection, good connection, it connects with the main server. So that's how this is the concept of MOOCIT replicated and is helpful in delivering courses to remote areas or island nations. More pictorial presentation of replicated MOOCIT concept. So you can see that there can be many such course can be on many servers in a local area, and then all that get connected to the main server and the connect. So connectivity issue at the local level is taken care by MOOCIT replicated. So as I have already mentioned, more to emphasize, MOOCIT is an indigenous MOOC management system developed in at IIT Kanpur, it's a Indian MOOC management system and designed for developing countries. So these are the things which are very important. Connectivity is a challenge in our country and many countries, so it takes care of that. The connection is not robust, which is taken care by MOOCIT. Indicator showing the bandwidth helps in that. the student can use other content delivery options like SD card and all that, stream the audio only and play it in sync with the slides, which is also taken care of bandwidth issue, and get the system to call you. This feature is also there offered in some courses when the learners are mainly from rural area and there are connectivity issue. Scalability and customizability is very important for a MOOC management system, and because one has to scale to offer a course to a large number of learners, 50,000, maybe 1 lakh, and it has to be cost effective. So scalability and customizability is very important. MOOC takes care of that. Next is integration with social networking. We have already talked about that, why it is important in present times, and what happens on MOOCIT platform. All the discussions in the course automatically get posted on a Facebook group and go out as tweets, also in tweet. And this happens in the opposite direction also. If somebody replies in the social networking platform, that gets imported to the course platform. So learning is integrated with social networking platforms. A student need not log into the course platform separately to follow and participate in the course, which is very special for young learners. Apart from these, forums are there on MOOCIT platform for in-depth discussion and anchored to the lectures. We will see that later. Audio in forums, if someone doesn't want to type, can record their topic and reply. Hangout for quick interaction with the instructors. Gradebook can be generated automatically, easy to compute the performance. You can set threshold for certification. If 40% marks is needed or 60% marks is needed, 80% attendance is needed, that can be set to create the certificate. Generate certificates automatically in one click. So MOOCIT Analytics. MOOCIT Analytics, simple and powerful interface to analyze course progress. It can monitor the progress of individual student. And we, even though this, on this online platform, there's no person-to-person contact, but through analytics that can be established, which is very important. Analytics is a very important feature. Can infer what action to take and when to take it based on a student behavior. So if a student is falling behind, not watching the lecture, a message can be sent to that student individually or a group of a student that you are missing something on the platform and please come back. In this atmosphere, it's very important to have connection with learners. So we will discuss that later. So now we will see the categories in the analytics section, which is a very special feature of MOOCIT platform. So registration related analytics, information collected from identity management used to check student profile, interaction analytics, analyze the behavior of a student, get feedback on provided material, evaluation analytics, and then server analytics. Now we will cover these. So registration analytics. So one can see that daily registration. We will see that when I give a demo, if time permits. So how many students, this is from a course offered on MOOCIT, and how many actually total learners were present on a particular day registered, and how many unique came on that day. So the green shows unique who joined, and this shows the aggregate. This is other information, gender and qualification. So one knows that how many postgraduate, and so the course content can be also designed based on the participants on the interest group. and age group here is there, and interactions now, interaction analytics. So one can see that how many students are active. So these, the blue is active students, daily engagement on Saturday. One can see that Tuesday, generally lectures are released on Saturday, Sunday, or so, then the peak comes, and when the quizzes are released, then the peak comes. So this analytics is helpful that way. How many participated in a discussion? This analytics is available. Aggregate lecture analysis. So visits is like an on MOOCIT platform. We see visits that somebody has come, clicked on a lecture and left. Or somebody has, how if we can set a criteria that if this percentage of lecture is viewed, watched, then it will come as views. So then one can see this information here. And this is individual lecture analysis. So this is very helpful. Like if green is distinct and blue is repeated. So if a portion of lecture is repeated again and again by learners, then it shows that there can be some complexity level in that portion. And instructor has to actually provide extra material or have a discussion to resolve this issue or to help learners. Text analysis is there, and this shows the sentiment analysis of forum, then the word clout, and network analysis is there. Network analysis is very interesting. This is from a course offered by Professor H.C. Verma. His name is known to everybody in the country. His book for JE entrance is read by every student, is used by every student who is aspiring to become an engineer. And so this shows that he was at the center. He started discussion, and one can see that there are many groups also in this discussion. So this is somebody who actually had a separate set of learners responding to his comments or his forum topic, his or her. Evaluation analysis. Performance overview of a quiz. So one can see that for a particular quiz given, what was the average mark and how many submissions have happened. Generally, we see very interesting phenomenon. If the quiz is released for a week, and then we say that only at the end, almost thousands of learners on one day, in one day, 500 submissions will be there, just like what happens in a classroom, examination hall. So these are the information which are available here. And performance analysis of each question. So this is the performance analysis for each question. If there are 20 questions, so students have done well for some questions, but some questions are got wrong by many. And if so happens that one question everybody is getting wrong, then it is an indicator for the instructor to check the question and see if the question could be from outside the syllabus or question is not framed properly and the students are not understanding. So that requires some intervention, which is very good to have in an online platform. Okay, monitor each student. So this is a file, Excel file, CSV file can be downloaded about performance of students. So one can see here, visits, all that information is available here. Now next, this is the interaction analytics available. So in this particular course of semiconductors offered by Professor H.C. Verma, who was a faculty here at IITK, and now he's an eminent professor here. In his course, there were so many registered students and these were active students. Means so many registered, but these many are actively participating in the course. So it is not necessary in a MOOC that everybody is actively participating. Everybody should participate actively. It's a learning system where there's a freedom to learn. Whatever you want to learn, how much you want to learn. And so active students in last 7 days, and all this information is there. So which can be very helpful. We'll see that later. Server statistics. So in last, this shows that how many logged in users were there in blue, and then student watching videos, how many are watching videos, load average. Actually, this helps the platform manager to scale the accessibility of platform. So, and what devices are being used, that is, information is also there in MOOCIT Analytics, device names, device used. So we have seen this transition happening like 4 years back. Desktop users were very in large number, and now that phone users, smartphone users are almost double in number than what it used to be 4 years back. This is also interesting, the information. This is very useful for the platform designer and those who manage platform technically. And so this is an overview of MOOCIT analytics and special features of MOOCIT platform. Now, just in 2019, MOOCIT became open source, and one can download and install on their server and create their own platform for running courses. So for that, we'll see that one can reach out to MOOCIT team for more information. So this is the website of MOOCIT platform, MOOCIT.in, and there one can go and check the features here. So if you want to install on your premise, you can, the information is given here. Or MOOCIT can be also used as a hosted version. For both, you can contact MOOCIT team and get help. So next is, if you want to learn more about MOOCIT platform, its features, MOOCIT team had offered a course MOOC with MOOCIT, which started in January 2020 and completed. It was a 4-week course. And what it takes to offer a MOOC and what is a MOOCIT platform, and all this is discussed in this course. Our instructor in charge is Professor T.V. Prabhakar. And then all the experienced members of MOOCIT team, they have given information lectures in this course, and it is a very valuable resource. You can check it out. It's very simple. You can just go sign up, and then after signing up, you can enroll and access the course. Now, next, this is the course listing of MOOCIT courses offered on MOOCIT platform. You can find them. It's free of cost. You can enroll in any course and learn. And there's no limit. MOOC means massive open online course. Open means anybody can access it. There's no restriction. There's no limit that somebody has to give you permission. It's easily accessible. Only for certification and on some platform, there is a charge. So these are many platforms, as I had discussed in my lecture in the beginning, which are actually powered by MOOCIT, MOOC management system. AG MOOCs is one of them. And this is the website, and there are 27 courses on this, 24 unique courses and 27 offerings. And this is basically run by Mookit team. And we have, it started in 2015. And so far we have offered 27 courses, 8-week courses, 6-week courses. And as I had mentioned that it takes 6 months to run a course, not just to start preparation. So this is about one of the platforms. And this is MOOC for Development platform for Commonwealth of Learning Canada. And the courses offered by them appear on this platform. You can go check it out and take any course. I will give a quick demo now. So just a minute, I'm just taking a little bit of time. Maybe we will take now questions. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm not able to share my screen. So can I just decrease it and go and access my Chrome setting?
Ma'am, as you feel comfortable, ma'am.
Okay. So let's have the questions answer session now.
Okay, ma'am. It was from the audience side. That can you please briefly demonstrate the process of uploading content in Mookit platform?
Just a minute. Okay, share. Okay. Okay. I will just cover this one more slide and then we will take the questions. We have discussed about learning management system and MOOC management systems. So this is important information. Learning management systems are basically class centric and MOOC management systems are content centric. What it means is that here in MOOC management system, the content is provided and a learner learns independently, so gets plenty of time to complete the activity. And availability of learning management system is limited because instructor has to give permission to join. But in MOOC management system, the availability is open. Anybody can join. There's permission is not required. Audience size in LMS classrooms is small. In MOOC management system, it is like, as I mentioned, 50,000 learners had joined a course offered by Professor H.C. Verma, which was learning experiments through simple, learning physics through simple experiments. And one can just imagine, a class size of 50,000. It's just not possible. It is only possible through MOOC management systems. Learning style in an LMS is in group, and in MMS, it is individual. One learns alone. There is no group activity. You learn, you take quiz, you submit your assignment, and it's an individual. Now, I would just like to mention here that Mookit is not a company. Mookit was seeded by initial funding from TechCrypt IITK, which is a teaching facility. Teacher improvement is like workshops for teachers are held. And Commonwealth of Learning supported Mookit by using Mookit in various courses across the world through the twin initiatives, MOOCs for Development and AG MOOCs. So support has come from Commonwealth of Learning. And Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission for Teacher and Teaching, a scheme of MHRD, Government of India. It gave a fillip through substantial funding and support for MOOCIT development and brought it to this stage. So we are very thankful for their support. In the end, I would like to say that MOOCIT, you can check the MOOCIT features by going through MOOC with MOOCIT course and contact MOOCIT team from MOOCIT.in. And there is a contact point from where you can contact. And you can install it on your premise. You can have a hosted version and you explore MOOCIT on your own and see how it can help you to reach out to large number of learners through a MOOC. So with this, I would end my talk and we can have a question answer session now.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. From the audience side, there's a question that what's the procedure to host or manage the course in MOOCIT?
Okay, so that's what I was saying, that I showed the website MOOC with MOOCIT, MOOCIT.in, right? So you can go to that website and then there is an option which I had showed in my, one slide, that you can download it on your premise or you can have a hosted version. So you click on that and then you will see how to contact MOOCIT team to host a course on MOOCIT platform.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay. Another one is, can you please elaborate the replicated MOOCIT?
Sure. Yeah, it's difficult to imagine. So the replicated MOOCIT concept is like, this is replicated MOOCIT concept is useful for learners in remote areas. Or it is useful for island nations, right? So like a main server is there where the course platform is, and then like the learners are in remote areas on a small island. So in that case, in that remote area on the server, the course material can be provided. And everybody, the learners in that area, remote area, will access only that local server. They don't have to connect with the main server. So that, they can connect through Wi-Fi, they can connect through, they don't require internet connectivity. And then the local server connects with the main server and syncs the data. So that is the concept of replicated MOOCIT.
Thank you, ma'am. Another one is, can we use it for a classroom with size of about 100 students or so?
The size is unlimited. I just mentioned that 50,000 had registered in the physics course offered by Professor S.C. Verma, learning physics through simple experiments. Imagine 50,000. And in AG MOOC, we have minimum 10,000 students in each course. At a time, right now, we are offering three courses. So 10,000 in each course, there are 30,000 students on the platform.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
And I would just mention one more thing, like AG MOOC platform is 5-year-old platform. There are 70,000 registered learners on that platform. And every time we offer a new course, we send mail to all our registered learners. And in no time, we have like 5,000 students registered in the course whenever a new course is offered. So that is magic of MOOCs, yeah.
Okay, ma'am. There's another question from Dr. Anita that, ma'am, as an individual teacher, can I assess MOOCIT colleges using another platform?
Please repeat it.
There's a question that somebody is asking that, as an individual teacher, can I assess MOOCIT college, like her college is using some another platform?
This will depend on their college policy, I would say. Yeah, if offering if it is only for college learners, then one will have to go through the college policy. If one is going global or going for a larger audience all over the country, then they can offer their course on MOOCIT.
Another one is that how such a large number of assignments are graded?
Yeah, assignment grading is difficult. So for that, in those courses where the student number is so high, it is basically multiple choice questions. Great, yeah.
Somebody asked it's by Mintu Bhattacharya that he's asking that I have enrolled in the MOOCIT as a student. Do I have to enroll again as a teacher?
No. Anybody who is joining to learn a course is a student on MOOCIT platform. Only the person who is offering the course is teacher. So even if you're a faculty and you are learning, then you are a student.
A mediocre teacher explains. A good teacher demonstrates. And a great teacher inspires. A journey which began over 100 years ago, this is the story of Guru Har Gobind Sahib Khalsa College, also known as the Wonder in Rural Hinterland.
More than a university, you know.